Thanks for joining me, dear viewer, on this visit to Crocodylus Park, Darwin, Australia. It's an excellent park and totally private funded. It not only has an excellent collection of crocodiles and alligators, but quite a few other animals as well, lions and tigers, leopards, and so on. If you want to know more about it, there's an outstanding website which takes you through the park step by step. It's well worth looking at. This is the website page which outlines the various tours. We managed to attend the 10 o'clock, 12 o'clock, and even the 2 o'clock tour where the crocodiles were fed. They were excellent and gave us a lot of good information about crocodiles. Their photocopied map, which they provided us on arrival, is not the best quality, but it does give an indication of where everything is located. I quickly learned that crocodiles are incredibly dangerous and have very large teeth, particularly the saltwater variety. This is a crocodile trap used to trap live crocodiles. We looked at the alligators as well, found in the southeastern part of the United States. They're not nearly as aggressive as the crocodiles, but they can still eat you. Alligators have a much more rounded snout. These are big alligators. Now we'll move on to the Australian freshwater crocodiles. They're not quite as large as the saltwater, but they're still incredibly vicious. Crocodiles are bred at the park, and there are literally hundreds of them in some large pools. These smaller freshwater crocodiles are quite agile and can jump out of the water to grab meat suspended from a line over the pool. Look at them all. The sides of the pool are lined with plastic so as not to damage their hides. The hides may be used to make purses or belts or other tourist items. A leaping freshwater crocodile. Now it's on to the saltwater crocodiles, the largest and most dangerous Australian animal. One of the features of the tour is that we got to hold a small crocodile with its mouth firmly closed by a rubber band so it wouldn't bite. However, the tail can swing and still hit you. The instructor gives some guidelines on how to hold the crocodile. My traveling companion Richard has a go at holding this crocodile and manages it without any difficulty. There is an excellent viewing platform over the pens for saltwater crocodiles, and the tourists walk along and watch them being fed. The guides climbed into the pens and slapped the water with a ball or a big metal pole, and the crocodiles would come charging out. It was very risky business, and the guide was very quick at climbing the fence. The guide explained that if you were caught by a crocodile, it would shake you violently and could break your spine before pulling you under the water. Hitting it on the snout or trying to gouge out its eyes was really quite ineffective. The only safety is not to be taken. Here's an airboat such as is used during the wet season. We took a look at some of the other animals. Quite a comprehensive zoo. The water buffalo was quite interesting. There's lots of these wandering around wild in the Northern Territory, even though a lot were killed during a massive cull in the 1980s and 1990s. Emus are native to Western Australia and are found quite often in the wild. They're quite a big bird, and I've clocked them running along beside my car at 40 kilometers an hour. There's quite a large range of different types of monkeys, and the signs were quite valuable in explaining a bit about them. Unfortunately, it's very hard to photograph them inside their steel mesh pens. The pig-tailed macaque This monkey was quite interested in grooming the hairs of the guide's arm. Crocodylus has some very impressive tigers. Tigers are getting quite rare in the wild. The park also has three of the four existing ocelots found in Australia, and they're very cute. It's also got a leopard. There are lots of lions, and they're very impressive. Dingoes are still found in Australia. Crocodylus. I do recommend this park, dear viewer, if you're visiting Darwin. It's very interesting and located right near the central city. Thanks for joining me on this quick trip to Crocodylus Park in Darwin, Northern Territory, Australia. Have a good day.